All right, here's the deal. Transitioning out of sports is not easy. I wish it was, but it's not. It may feel exciting at first. I know it did for me. You know, you got this brand new world. You feel like a baby all over again. You're outside of this little box, this tunnel vision. You got all these different options, and it can be very exciting. But once that time passes by a little bit and time kind of settles in, the question still remains, what next? So if you are someone who is stuck in that phase right now, and you're in the transition and you're still stuck asking that question of what do I do now, then stick around. I'm going to share with you 8 of the best career options for athletes once they're done playing the game. If you're new, welcome. I'm Jelani Jenkins. I'm a former NFL athlete and now mindset coach. And the whole purpose of this channel is to share tips and advice for athletes who are transitioning and navigating that transition out of the game. So if you vibe with that, if that's your thing, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button and click the bell to be notified every time I post a new video. And so when it comes to the transition, one of the things that I help my clients get clear on is the power of their inner athlete. It's that intangible skill set that is gold in the business world. And so the key is, if you approach life like you approach your sport, you're gonna have success. Okay, it's that simple. Treat life like you treated the game, and you will have a ton of success, okay? Now, these 8 best career options, I've graded them. In my opinion, the 4 key elements of a great career transition for athletes. The first is ease of transition. How easy is it to transition into this new field? And let's just assume that you haven't been studying it all your life. How simple is the transition? The next is opportunity to thrive. How do my athlete skill sets match up in this business, in this industry? Then it's opportunities for fulfillment. The things that I loved most about being an athlete in my sport, how does that align with this next industry, this next career? And then finally, financial opportunity. Ching ching. That's what that's all about, okay? So ease of transition, opportunity to thrive, opportunities for fulfillment, and financial opportunity, okay? Now, if you have a career that is able to have a really good score on those 4 things, then we're talking a really, really great opportunity, especially for athletes, okay? So coming in at number 8, we have physical therapy and athletic trainer. For majority of the people, that's not that simple of a transition, okay? But it is along the same lines of sports, okay? You're still close to sports, so the transition is okay, but the learning curve is still a little bit high. So I gave that a 7 on ease of transition. And then when it comes to opportunities to thrive, there is a pretty high level of opportunity. And the reason that is because you've been around the athletic training room. As a physical therapist, as an athletic trainer, you have to be able to relate to the athletes who come in every single day. And you have to be able to have that intuitive understanding of what they're going through so that you can help them out in the best way possible. So I gave opportunities to thrive a 9. Now, for opportunities for fulfillment, I gave it an 8. There's still a lot of opportunities for fulfillment because you're still in the space of sports, okay? And you're actually helping individuals who are in the same position as you really be able to achieve their dreams. Okay, so the fact that you're able to remain close to it, you're able to still maintain that fulfillment. And then for financial opportunity, we got a whopping 9, okay? A whopping 9. That means ching ching, okay? You were talking on average 100 to 120K a year, okay, depending on your level. But there's still some really great financial opportunities. So at the end of the day, physical therapy and athletic training came in at number 8. With a score of 33, all right? So for number 7, we have coach and teacher. Now for coach and teacher, the ease of transition is a 10. We truly intuitively understand the coaching student relationship, the coaching player relationship, the teacher student relationship. We understand that at an intuitive level. It's a very simple transition for us because we've been in that world. Now, the opportunities to thrive, for this, I gave it an 8. You do understand how to bring the best out of people, okay? Other players, other teammates around you. You have a natural understanding of how to do that, but it does take a little bit of skill set. You have to understand psychology. You have to understand how to treat every player differently, every student differently depending on who they are. Okay, you can't treat them all the same. So it does take a little bit of skill set, but you naturally understand it. So I gave it an 8. Okay, then opportunities for fulfillment, I gave it a 9. There's still a lot of opportunities, okay, to be around the sport, to be around the things that you love, and you have that intuitive connection with the players because you've been in that sport. It's a natural transition because of that. And then for financial opportunity, we have a 7. Okay, you got, okay, you know. Now it depends, because there's some coaches like a Nick Saban in the world or Urban Meyer of the world, they got all the bread that you can think of. Okay, so it depends. You go into coaching, you go into teaching, you're going to be somewhere in the $50,000 to $70,000 a year on average, okay? So I gave the financial opportunity a 7 for that. And now this makes the score for coaching and trainers, coaching and teachers, a 34, okay? So a little bit better than physical therapy and training, but not quite. The 6th best career option for an athlete is a sales representative. Right, sales representative. I gave the ease of transition an 8, okay? It's still a bit of a learning curve. You still gotta understand some sales jargon, you know, how to really do the psychology thing, how to create rapport. All these things we're naturally great at, but you still got a little bit of a learning curve to go through. So I gave it an 8. Okay, this is where sales really kicks in. I gave opportunities to thrive a 10 for sales, and I'll tell you why. Athletes have a very, very high opportunity to thrive in any type of sales position because of our resilience when it comes to the word no. And also, there is an easy metric for success. We're used to wins, we're used to losses, we're used to seeing stats. Sales, you either get the sale or you don't, okay? And a lot of the financial opportunity is based on commission. So if you're competitive, if you're an athlete, okay, when you see that the wins chalking up, okay, I got this sale, I got this sale, I got this sale, it activates something deep inside of you, okay? And that's why athletes are really good when it comes to sales and being in a sales rep position. Opportunities for fulfillment, I gave it an 8. It's not really dealing with sports, but again, you still get that competitive nature. You still get that easy metric for success. You understand, okay, the more calls that I make, the more opportunities that I get to get the sale, the more sales I get, the more money I make. Okay, so you get the chance to get that competitive edge and that fulfillment as you move towards that. And then financial opportunity, I gave an 8 as well. Okay, it's about middle of the bunch. And depending on if you're a sales manager, if you're just starting out, okay, you're looking at somewhere on average between $70,000 and $90,000, which is still pretty good. So overall, the sales rep score is a 34. It's tied with coaching and teacher. So still another great option. Now, coming in at number 5, we have a sleeper pick, okay? We have film and television. Now, film and television is something that is not easy to transition into. I gave the ease of transition a 7, okay? It's a very, you know, you have to have a certain skill set. You have to practice that skill set for a long time to really get good at it, to really be at an elite level at it. No matter where you are in the film industry, whether you're a writer, whether you want to be a director, a videographer, whether you want to hold the lights, okay, whether you want to do the recruiting, okay, costume design. There are a lot of different specialties, but you do need a lot of experience in those realms. So the transition is not that easy. Now, when it comes to opportunities to thrive, film gets a 9 for opportunities to thrive, okay? And the reason it gets that high of a score is because we understand preparation and we understand being ready for the magical moment. That magical moment being game day, okay? When preparation meets the competition. And that's one of the real keys of success in film, is having the ability to go from the rehearsals, from the table readings, to the actual film set, when you have a limited amount of time to make magic happen, and the whole team has to be ready for that moment and operate like this, or somebody's gonna lose a lot of money. Opportunities to thrive is very high because we understand how to recognize that magic moment and how to perform at that magic moment. Now, opportunities for fulfillment is a 10, pretty much for that very exact reason. When you're on that film set, you recognize how to play as a team, how to play as a unit. It's a very team environment. Everybody has to be on their P's and Q's. Everyone has to do their specific job in order for that moment to be captured at a very high level. And that's how it's able to transition once it actually gets on film in front of the actual viewer. So the fact that that team atmosphere provides a level of accountability and high performance, that is why the opportunity for fulfillment for me, in my opinion, is a 10 when it comes to film. And then finally, for financial opportunity, I gave film an 8. It varies greatly depending on what position, okay? If you are an assistant, you're not going to get paid the same as the number one actor on the film or the director of the film or the producers, okay? But we're talking on average $70,000 to $100,000 a year as you get the ball rolling in your film industry, okay? Another very great key to understand when it comes to film is, in television, is you need connections. People want to be around athletes, okay? You have a really great opportunity to get inside of the door of any film production because you have a unique story to tell. And that's why film comes in at a 34. And so before we go into number 4, my question for you is, has any of these surprised you this far? If so, go ahead and leave a comment below and let me know your thoughts, okay? These are largely opinion-based, but ultimately it has a lot of truth to it as well. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below on which one surprised you thus far and what you would have chosen differently. For number 4, we have speaking. Speaking is a very, very great option for athletes, okay? Just like I said before, we have a unique story to tell, okay? That ease of transition, I gave it a 10. All you need is your voice, you need some communication skills, and you need a unique story, and you need to have the ability to be able to speak in front of people, which is not something that cannot be learned rather quickly. Okay, it takes a little bit of getting over fears if you're not used to public speaking, but it's something that is a very simple transition, not a high learning curve for us. I gave it a 10. Now, opportunities to thrive, I gave it an 8. Okay, like I said, that story is very, very powerful, and it's something that you can use in order to truly captivate an audience. Chances are you have fans. Even if they're not fans of you, they may be fans of the team that you played for, or they may be fans of the league that you played for. So you can really lean into that to really captivate someone's audience, an audience with a story to tell. So that's why I gave it an 8. There's a really great opportunity for fulfillment. I gave it an 8. The really key aspect of it is you're in front of an audience when you're speaking, okay? You're having people, they're captivated by you. There's a chance for, you know, a standing ovation. And we're used to that, okay? We're used to that as athletes, okay? And that's fulfilling. Ultimately, that's fulfilling to know that you did a good job and to see the reward because of it. So I gave it an 8. And then finally, financial opportunity, I also gave an 8. So there are a lot of opportunities to make a lot of money doing this, okay? I'm talking anywhere from 80 to 100,000 and even more, depending on how popular you get. There's a lot of flexibility. You can travel, okay? You can make moves and really have a great time in that profession. So speaking comes in at 34. We have a nice little tie for 34 right here. And now coming in at number 3, we have sports management. Now, sports management, when it comes to the ease of transition, I gave it a 9. It's not something that's too difficult for athletes to transition into. What you have as an advantage, obviously, is your experience around sports, understanding how organizations are run just by looking around you, okay? Looking and seeing what time the meetings are set up for you, looking and seeing any transactions that are made in terms of bringing new people on. You have an intuitive understanding of it. So the transition is not that difficult. And then for opportunities to thrive, I gave it a 9 as well. Athletes are already really good at sports, obviously, and then athletes are also good at business naturally. So having that great mixture makes it a really, really great opportunity, which is why I gave it a 9. And then opportunities for fulfillment, we gave it an 8, okay? So you're still able to make high-level decisions when it comes to the success of some sports. You're not necessarily on the field. You're not necessarily the first point of contact when it comes to a win and loss. You're a little bit more removed making the high-level decisions that lead to that, which is also still fulfilling. Okay, it's also an adrenaline rush. And then finally, for financial opportunity, we gave it a 9, okay? We're talking about Ching Ching. Ching Ching. We have opportunities to make a lot of money in that sports management realm, especially if you're talking like, you know, saying owner status, okay? If you think high, okay, we got a lot of great opportunity. But on average, we're talking $80,000 to like $150,000 a year. There's a lot of great opportunity for it, okay? And so ultimately, sports management came in at a 35. Now at number two, we have sports broadcasting and sports journalism. Y'all knew this was going to come up. This is a great, great, great ability to transition into, okay? The ease of transition, I gave it a 9. You're speaking about sports. You're speaking about athletes, okay? The reason it's not a 10 is because you have to understand a little bit of kind of the background work of how to, you know, captivate an audience for that long, speaking about sports. There is a lot of skill set that goes into it, so I gave it a 9. Opportunities to thrive, it also got a 9. You have a credible opinion. You have a very high IQ when it comes to sports. Okay, so if there's somebody else sitting in that position who didn't play sports, you're obviously going to have a really high advantage. You're going to thrive in that realm. So I gave that a 9. Opportunities for fulfillment, that also gets a 9. You are speaking about what you love. All right, so you're going to feel fulfilled. You're going to be able to remain close, and you're also going to have to deal with pressure situations, which is good, which is challenging, which a lot of athletes enjoy, and I think you do too. Okay, and if you're a sports journalist, you have to write up something really quickly. But the fact that you have that high IQ and that natural understanding for sports really makes it a very viable option for you and a lot of fun as well. And then for financial opportunity, we gave it an 8. We're talking anywhere from $70,000 to $100,000 a year. So it's still a really, really great opportunity. And now, finally, let's talk about number one. What do y'all think it is? What do you think it is? Let me know. What do you think it is? Well, here's what it is. Number one. The best career option for athletes when they leave the game is entrepreneurship and business owner. So let's talk about ease of transition. I gave it an 8. I'm not going to say it's simple. It's not easy to transition in entrepreneurship. There are so many businesses that fail. I don't even know what the stat is. But still, this is something that naturally requires that championship mindset. Okay? That athletic mindset, win attitude is gold as an entrepreneur. And the opportunities to thrive, like I said, you don't get much better than the athlete, in my opinion, okay? I gave it a 10. That mindset of an athlete is gold, and it wins, and it wins, and it wins. And you understand how to play as a team. As an entrepreneur, as a business owner, you have to create a team around you. And you understand how to play as a team. And you understand how to do your job and have someone who's better at you in another job do their job. Okay? And you're able to create a team around you that's able to do that. Opportunities for fulfillment, gave it a 9. You're able to live out your dream. Okay? You're able to have an idea and see it come to life. That is powerful. That is super powerful. Anybody who goes through and has that entrepreneurship bug is going to feel fulfilled, but especially as an athlete. Because let's be honest, and I guess I'll just speak for myself. We don't really want to work for anybody else, okay? After you've been to, you know, a certain level, you want to just, you know, really be able to control your destiny, essentially. And then for financial opportunity, I gave it another 9. Now, obviously, this is a high varied ratio. You got some entrepreneurs who are barely making $30,000 a year, $50,000 a year. You got some who are making $150,000 a year. So at the end of the day, go and do what you love to do. If you grew up loving music, then go make music. If you grew up riding horses, then go be an equestrian, okay? Ride some horses. Whatever it is you want to do, go do it. Do what you love, okay? Find ways to expand and evolve and do new experiences so that you learn all the different options, all the different passions that you may have that you may not even know you have yet. Find what you love and follow your passion, follow your dream, and believe you have the opportunity to do it and believe you have the ability to make it happen. And so last thing is this. Choosing the best career option is one thing. But actually going out and making and turning your dreams to reality is a whole different thing. So here's what I did. If you go ahead and take a look at the description below, you're gonna find a little treat, okay? I created a free guide for you called Turn Your Dreams to Reality. And I guarantee you, if you follow the steps in this guide, you will see a real transformation, I promise you, okay? And it's free, and it even includes a bonus meditation and a visualization for you to help speed up that process. But ultimately, you follow these steps. They're practical steps that you can use today to transform your life, okay, to get clear on what it is that you want and to have the tools in order to make those things a reality. And with all that is said, you are a champion. You always have been, and you always will be. I appreciate you for tuning in. Thank you, and I'll talk to you next time. Peace.